An in-depth look into masking controls in Final Cut Pro is about to begin in 3, 2... Get ready for a blast of knowledge, because we're going over all the controls for shape masks and draw masks in the Inspector. First, we'll apply a shape mask to our clip by navigating to the Effects menu, locating the shape mask, and dragging it onto our clip. Then, we'll navigate to the Inspector on the top right, and we'll first click Invert Mask to flip the areas masked in the clip. You may notice these amazing on-screen controls in the viewer. If you want to learn more about these controls, check out our other shape mask and draw mask tutorials linked in the description below. For this video, we'll focus on these controls in the Inspector. First, radius will change the mask's size. If we expand it, we can adjust the width of the mask with X and the height of the mask with Y. Curvature will change the mask shape between a rectangle or an oval. Fill opacity will adjust the opacity of the image inside the mask. Invert mask is a checkbox we can select to swap which areas are masked. View switches between the original image or composite image. Feather will soften the edges of the mask outward or inward. Falloff controls the spread and softness of the edges. Now that's some smooth, buttery falloff. Transforms lets you adjust the position, rotation, and scale of our mask. And Control Points gives us the option to convert the shape mask to a draw mask. Draw mask has a lot of the same controls as shape masks, with some notable differences. We can now select the shape type for the mask. We can change the whole mask to linear, Bezier, or B-spline. If you're interested on how these controls work, check out the videos linked in the description below. We'll set it back to linear. And the last difference with draw mask compared to shape mask is these control points controls at the bottom. We can use these handy value sliders to adjust the positions of each control point if desired. When creating any mask, definitely take advantage of the controls in both the viewer and Inspector to make the most of these amazing tools. Thanks to this tutorial, complex masks are no longer complex, and you are at a new level. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level. Want to learn a little bit more? Look at that, look at this, look at you go.